Chinese Basketball Association has always been a popular destination for ex-NBA superstars. Players with good or at least some NBA resume are requested in China. It's a place to earn good money as a foreign player and maybe get back some confidence to eventually return to the NBA. Hey guys, Purple Prince here, and today I'll take a look at ex-NBA superstars who are currently playing in CBA and how they are doing this season. So last week I made a video on OJ Mayo, who also plays in CBA, and that prompted me to do a deeper search on every ex-NBA player who currently plays in CBA. First, let me tell how this will work. I'll only talk about ex-NBA players who are playing this season in the CBA, and there are some players on current CBA teams who have been a part of an NBA team during the preseason or summer league, but I won't include those. So currently, out of 19 teams in the CBA, 15 teams feature at least one ex-NBA player. Let's start with the bottom feeders of the CBA, the Nanjing Tongxi Monkey King. They are the worst team in the league, having won only 7 out of 45 games, and their only ex-NBA player is Arnett Moultrie. Arnett Moultrie is a 6'11 power forward who played 2 seasons in the NBA for the Philadelphia Sixers. In total, he participated in 59 games and averaged 3.6 points and 3.1 rebounds. In CBA this season, Moultrie is averaging 25.7 points and 12.6 rebounds per game. He's the unquestioned leader of his team, albeit that has resulted in only 7 wins. Another outsider in the CBA this season, the Fujian Sturgeons. They have the worst defense in the league, and their only ex-NBA player is Andrew Nicholson. Andrew Nicholson played 5 seasons in the NBA, 4 of them with the Orlando Magic. In total 285 NBA games, he averaged 6 points and 3 rebounds. This season in CBA, he's averaging 22.7 points and 6.5 rebounds per game. He's the second leading scorer on his team, but he's super effective as he gets those stats in just 20.4 minutes per game and shoots 57.1% from the field and 43.4% from the three. The Shaanxi Longs have two ex-NBA players. Jamal Franklin played for 2 teams in the NBA and in total 24 games averaged 1.8 points. Currently, he's averaging a team-best 24.8 points, 9.4 assists, and 8.2 rebounds. Eric Moreland, a former NBA player who played 4 seasons in the league but participated in only 83 games and averaged 1.9 points and 3.7 rebounds. Currently, he's the best rebounder on his team, averaging 11.3 boards per game. He's also averaging 13.3 points per game. Next up, we have Guangzhou Long Lions. Their only NBA player is Maurice Spates. Spates had a long and successful career in the NBA. He became an NBA champion in 2015, played for 6 teams, and in total 705 NBA games, has averaged 7.9 points and 4.1 rebounds. This season in CBA, though, hasn't been too good. He has participated in only 28 games and has been on the court for only 12.6 minutes per game. Impressively though, in that little time, he has averaged 11.5 points and 5.4 rebounds on bad shooting numbers, just 40.4% from the field. The Shanghai Sharks. Jimmer Fredette, one of the best college players of all time. Well, the most exciting college players at least. He never found his place in the NBA, and he had his chances. He played for 5 NBA franchises, but in 241 games, he averaged just 6 points on 40% shooting from the field. In CBA, he has all the green light. He attempts more than 10 threes per game and is connecting on 40.2% of them. He's the best scorer on his team, averaging 27.3 points and 6.4 assists. Beijing Royal Fighters have had the most ex-NBA players playing for them this season. 5. Former NBA player Salah Mehri. The 7'2 center played 4 seasons in the NBA, all for the Dallas Mavericks, and in total 204 games, he averaged 3.4 points and 4 rebounds in 11.9 minutes per game. This season in CBA, he has participated in only 2 games, and averages 2.5 points and 1 rebound in 9.5 minutes per game. Sun Yu had a very short 10-game stint with the Lakers back in 2008. He scored a total of 6 points in his NBA career. In CBA, he's had a very poor season. In 23.5 minutes per game, he has averaged only 3.6 points and get this, on 23.5% shooting from the field and 20% from the 3-point line. Awful. Ekpe Udo, a veteran of four NBA teams. Center has participated in 384 NBA games and holds averages of 3.5 points and 2.9 rebounds per game. This season in China, has participated in only 7 games, has been on the court for an average of 17.3 minutes and averaged 9 points and 4.9 rebounds. Andrew Harrison spent 3 seasons in the NBA, played for 3 teams and had his most solid run with the Memphis Grizzlies, where he averaged 7.4 points. In total 145 NBA games, he has averages of 7 points and 2.8 assists per game. With the Royal Fighters this season, he's scoring 9.7 points per game, which is the 6th best result on his team. He's playing a mere 15.7 minutes per game. He's on the court less than he was in the NBA. And the best player for the Royal Fighters is Joe Young. Former NBA point guard played 3 seasons for the Indiana Pacers as a guard coming off the bench. In 127 total NBA games, he averaged 3.4 points per game. This season in CBA, he's the leading scorer and passer on his team, averaging 24 points and dishing out 6.1 assists. Okay guys, stick around, we're almost halfway. Dakari Johnson, a former center for the Oklahoma City Thunder back in 2018, played in 31 NBA games and was on the court for only 5.2 minutes per game and averaged 1.8 points and 1.1 rebounds. Currently, plays for the Qingdao Eagles, where he is one of the leaders, averaging 21 points and 13 rebounds per game. Dominique Jones, a guard who played 3 seasons for the Dallas Mavericks. In total 80 games, he averaged 3.1 points and 1.8 assists. In China, he's a superstar. He's the league leader in scoring and scores twice as much as anyone else on his team. But that comes at a cost. He's also attempting 29.4 shots per game, which is almost 3 times more as the next best player on his own team. He's also averaging 11.3 rebounds as a guard and 8.9 assists. The Sichuan Blue Whales have 3 former NBA players on their team. Russ Smith, who has this cool nickname Russdiculous, has played 3 seasons in the NBA for 2 teams, and in a total of just 27 games. He averaged 2 points on 31.9% shooting. In CBA this season, he played in only 3 games, and averaged 4.3 points in 3.7 minutes per game. Hamed Haddadi, former center for the Memphis Grizzlies and Phoenix Suns, has played in a total of 151 NBA games and averaged 2.2 points and 2.5 rebounds in 7 minutes per game. In CBA this season, he's averaging 18.3 points and 13.6 rebounds and as a center, is also the best passer and shot blocker on the team, averaging 6.3 assists and 1.6 blocks per game. And the best scorer on the Blue Whales is Marcus Georges Hunt. Last played in the NBA during the 2018 season for the Minnesota Timberwolves, and in total has played for 2 teams and 47 NBA games. He averaged 1.6 points per game. In China, he's the leader of his team as he averages 25.7 points per game on 47.8% shooting from the field and 37.9% from the 3. The Beijing Ducks are currently employing 2 former NBA players. Justin Hamilton, a former center for 4 NBA teams, has played in the NBA for 5 seasons and holds averages of 6.1 points and 3.6 rebounds in 113 NBA games. In CBA, he averages 16.7 points and 6.7 rebounds. And the best scorer for the Ducks is former NBA point guard Jonathan Gibson, who actually made his NBA debut at age 29. 2 seasons in the league, 2 teams, a total of 21 games, and averages of 6.7 points and 1.4 assists in 12.9 minutes per game. In Beijing, he's averaging 24.3 points and 3.7 assists per game, and is one of the league's best 3-point shooters, connecting on 41.5% of his 3-point attempts. 2 former NBA players are leading the Shandong Heroes in scoring. Lester Hudson, a 4-year NBA veteran, has played for 5 teams in his NBA career and participated in 57 games, averaging 4.7 points and 1.4 rebounds. He's the leading scorer for the Heroes, averaging 24.1 points, 6.3 rebounds, and 5.9 assists. The other one is Manny Harris. He also played in the league for 4 seasons, 3 teams and 93 total games. Averages of 6.2 points and 2.7 rebounds in 17.1 minutes per game. In CBA, alongside Hudson, he's averaging 22.1 points, 5.9 rebounds, and 4 assists per game. The Zhejiang Lions this season have employed three former NBA players. Probably the most recognizable name on this list is Wilson Chandler. He was playing in the NBA just last season for the Brooklyn Nets. The bulk of his career was spent with the Denver Nuggets, where he was their starting small forward. In total, has participated in 676 NBA games, most of them as a starter, and holds averages of 12.5 points and 5.3 rebounds. This season in the CBA hasn't been the best. Chandler has participated in only 3 games and averaged 15.3 points and 7.7 rebounds per game in 21 minutes of action. Kay Felder. That 5'9 point guard played 2 seasons in the NBA, is a former member of 3 NBA teams, and in total 58 games averaged 3.8 points and 1.3 assists on 36.4% shooting from the field. In China, this season he has played in only 7 games and averages 12.4 points and 4.5 assists in 25 minutes per game. The best former NBA player on the Lions is the relatively unknown Miroslav Radulica. His stint in the NBA was quite short, as during 2 seasons he participated in only 53 NBA games. Being on the court for just 9.2 minutes, he averaged 3.6 points and 2.1 rebounds per game. On the Lions though, he's the team's best player, averaging 23.6 points, 10.5 rebounds and 4.5 assists per game. 3 more ex-NBA players are performing for the Xinjiang Flying Tigers. Ian Clark, a former NBA champion with the Warriors, is a team member but hasn't played a game for them this season, so we're gonna skip him. Joe Key played in 2 NBA seasons with the Rockets, was like the third center off the bench and played in only 19 total games and averaged 1.3 points and 1.2 rebounds in 6.6 minutes. For the Tigers, he's the second leading scorer and averages 20.8 points and 12.1 rebounds per game. The best player is Donatas Mateiunas. Once a solid power forward for the Houston Rockets, has played in a total of 251 NBA games and averages 7.3 points and 3.8 rebounds. His stats in China are superb. 22.6 points, 14.6 rebounds and 4.4 assists on 60.3% shooting from the field. Okay, and now we go to the best teams in the CBA, which each has 2 former NBA players. The Lightning Flying Leopards are currently employing OJ Mayo and Jonathan Simmons. OJ Mayo I just talked about in my last NBA video, so if you want to find out his NBA journey in detail, please check my previous video. I'll just repeat myself and say that he's averaging 20.5 points and 4.9 rebounds this season in the CBA. And Jonathan Simmons has played in 4 NBA seasons, the most successful being a 2-season stint in Orlando. In total, a participant of 258 NBA games, holds averages of 8.3 points and 2.4 rebounds. In CBA, he has played in just 16 games and averaged 9 points and 2.4 rebounds in 12.1 minutes per game. And the last team, and the best team in the CBA currently, the Guangdong Southern Tigers. Sonny Weems was last seen in the NBA during the 2015-16 season. During his NBA career that spanned 4 seasons, he played for 4 different NBA franchises, and in 183 games averaged 6.5 points and 2.2 rebounds per game. For the Southern Tigers, he does a little bit of everything. He's the second best scorer on his team, averaging 16.5 points, 5 assists and 4.3 rebounds. The best player is former NBA journeyman Marcin Brooks. He had a quite interesting NBA career. He was a starter for the New Jersey Nets back in 2012, then was a bench player for the rest of his career and changed 4 teams before going back to the NBA to play for the Memphis Grizzlies, where in a stretch of 7 games he averaged 20.1 points per game. Anyways, in a total 200 games, he averaged 8 points and 2.1 rebounds. In CBA, however, he's the leading scorer for the best team in the league, averaging 27.6 points and 4.1 assists on 53% shooting from the field and 41% from the 3. So there you go, guys. I think I covered everyone. If not, please let me know in the comments. This was a long one, so I hope you enjoyed it. And if you still hear me talking, that means that you watched the whole thing, which means that you're officially a member of our Purple community. Thank you. But which of these former NBA players has the best chance to return to the league one day? Which one is the most disappointing, even in CBA? If you have anything on your mind, please write that down in the comment section. If you appreciate my work, please leave a like for the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Enable bell notifications to not miss out on basketball content in the future, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks. This is Purple Prince, and I'm out.